are here because we want to worship our God on this beautiful, feels like summer, but it's still spring morning. And I am so happy to have everyone in this place, happy to see friends and family, old faces. And I just want to invite everybody to either come closer to the stage if you wish, or just stand up with me. And we want to worship together this morning. For those that are online, we always broadcast exactly at 10:30, and our tech team is hard at work making sure that every Sunday is available for somebody that maybe in the future will find this service, or we know that a team in Africa is watching us faithfully, and we thank you, and we want the Lord to bless you where you are. Our psalm, our verse that we read almost every time when we worship is Psalm 34:1. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul makes its boast in the Lord. Let the humble hear and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I want us all to just bow our heads, and I will pray as we start this time of worship. Lord, I've come to you this morning with a thought, Lord, with a mindset that says, God, I want to give you all of me, and I want to worship. Lord, I want to give you everything that I have in my heart, Lord. And I pray for the same thing for the church here, Lord. This church is a church that people that come here seek earnestly to see you, to feel you, to know you. Lord, we pray earnestly that those that are here in this house feel your presence. Let your Holy Spirit come down upon us, Lord. Teach us the things we need to be learning, Lord. Comfort us, those that need to be comforted. Heal that those that need to be healed, Lord. And at the same time, Lord, we ask those that are watching online, may we participate all together in a time of worship, to worshiping your name this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Song is called Champion.
I've tried so hard to see it. Took me so long to believe it. That you chose someone like me to carry your victory. Perfection could never earn it. What we don't deserve, and you take the broken things and raise them to glory. You are my champion. Giants fall when you stand undefeated. Every battle you've won, I am who you say I am. My champion. Giants fall when you stand undefeated. Every battle you've won, I am who you say I am. You crown me with confidence. I am seated in the heavenly place. Undefeated by the power of your name. I am seated in the heavenly place, undefeated, with the one who has conquered it all. Jesus has given me. You are the Word at the beginning, one with God, the Lord Most High. Your hidden glory in creation, now revealed in you are Christ. What a beautiful name it is, what a beautiful name. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus. You are the one forever faithful. And Jesus, you bore the cross. Sin was great, your love is greater. What could separate us now? What a wonderful name it is. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a wonderful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. The death could not hold you, the veil tore before you, you silenced the boast of sin. Heavens are roaring, the praise of your glory, for you are raised to life again. You have no rival, you have no equal, now and forever, God, you reign. Yours is the kingdom, yours is the glory. The name above.
go back to the bridge, I wanted the whole church to concentrate its voices on this second half of the song. Remember that we just celebrated Easter holiday not too long ago, and Jesus conquered death on Easter holiday. He is the only one in history to have died, risen again, and have never died ever again. The veil was torn in the temple, as it says in the second line, which meant that God permanently removed the barrier between us and him. From now on, we don't have to travel to Jerusalem to talk to God. The Holy Spirit is in you. Your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit. You just have to ask and pray that he resides in you and fills you up. Let's all sing this again. Death could not hold you.
Death could not hold you. The veil torn before you. Silence the boast of sin and grave. The heavens are roaring, the praise of your glory. For you are raised to life again. And you have no rival, you have no equal. Now and forever, God, you reign. And yours is the kingdom, yours is the glory, yours is the name above all names. What a powerful name it is, what a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a powerful name it is, nothing can stand against. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus.
I want the whole church to go into a community prayer where we give the Lord praise this morning. Let's give him praise. Let's make this a prayer. We don't spend time asking for the request that he already knows is on our hearts, but let's just give him praise and let's just give him glory that he is the one forever. Amen. continue to praise the Lord because He is the majesty. Church can sing the chorus one more time. Majesty.
Majesty. Majesty. Your grace has found me just as I am. Empty-handed but alive in your hands. Majesty, forever I am changed by your love. In the presence of your majesty, majesty.
I didn't ask the worship team this morning, but if there's somebody that on their heart feels inclined to pray, I want somebody from the worship team to pray to end our morning. If not, I will take the lead.
We come before you in this morning in utmost gratitude that you have brought us to this place that we may worship your holy name. I thank you from the bottom of my heart for each person gathered here, dear Lord. And I thank you that you've continued to walk with us, that your hand of protection has been over us. I thank you, dear Lord Jesus, that you've been a light in our lives, that you have not left us idle, that you have not turned your face away from us. I thank you, dear Lord, for your Son that you put upon a cross. Jesus, I thank you that you came down on this earth, a Prince of Heaven, and you humbled yourself so much so that you were ridiculed and you were mocked and beaten by so many people, by the same people that you had come to save. I thank you, dear Lord, that you continued on that path to sacrifice yourself for us. That as you prayed in the Garden of Gethsemane, you did not give up, and that you continued forward to fulfill the will of the Father. I thank you that you offered so many of us salvation, that it is so free to take for ourselves. I thank you for your grace, for your love and your mercies that are renewed each and every day. Lord, I pray for each heart here, that they would open up to you, that they would reveal all of their hurt and their pain, that they would relieve themselves of the burdens of this world, that the darkness that surrounds them, that they would come to the light, come to the Father, come to the cross. I thank you, dear Lord, for the blood that was shed. I thank you that it covers each and every sin, that we cannot go too far, that no matter where we go, you are always with us, and that you call us back to you with open arms. Lord, I thank you, and I pray that each one of us would live a life that glorifies you, that we would praise your name no matter where we go, that we would live a life that shows others the love of the Father, that we would bring others to you, that we would be witnesses, that we would be fishers of men, dear Lord. Help us to be examples, to show others how good you are, to point them to the cross, to turn them away from the burdens of this world, to show them that there is a Savior, that there is peace so unfathomable. There is rest, and there's no need to carry all the burden on their own. Amen. There is a Savior who cares for our souls. And he showed us this love by dying upon a cross for our sins. At a time when we did not deserve it. Even today, we do not deserve your grace. But I thank you that you give it to us either way. Lord, I pray that you'd be with the rest of this service. Let your Holy Spirit rest upon us, that we would feel your presence, that we would hear your voice and not the voice of man, dear Lord. I thank you, and in your mighty name I pray. Amen.
Amen. I feel led by the Spirit this morning to say one more prayer for all the broken hearts that are existing this morning, for all the pain that's going around the world. Lord God, now that we've worshiped your name, Lord, we want to ask that you resolve and bring resolution and bring healing and sometimes miraculous needs to those that are in so much pain around this world. Lord, yesterday 10 people were killed in a supermarket shooting, oh Lord, in Buffalo. And we can't even imagine how many hundreds of lives are affected by this pain and tragedy. Lord, we pray above all, Lord, that you bring comfort, somehow bring comfort and sense and wisdom to the people that are just asking, why God, why so much pain, why did I lose my loved one? Lord, we ask that you bring justice to those that are involved. Lord, at the same time, we pray for Ukraine. It's almost 3 months since they've been under constant attack from their neighbor, oh Lord. We pray for the hearts of the Ukrainians and the hearts of the Russians, that Lord, that you do miraculous work in this area, Lord. All of Europe is struggling, Romania is struggling, everyone, Poland is struggling to try to support the needs. Help us to find little ways that we can be a help, Lord. If not here, Lord, asking for your Holy Spirit to resolve the needs. We pray for those of our church that are in Romania right now and those of our church that are in Canada, that you please, Lord, bless them and keep them safe until they return back here. Again, we want to dedicate this time of worship to you, Jesus, and we worship you this morning. In your name we pray. Amen. Well, thank you very much, everyone, for worshiping with us together this morning. I want to ask everyone to just shake hands one more time and say, welcome to Hosanna Christian Church, those that were able to come during worship. Worship team, thank you very much for singing your hearts out. And thank you for being available to worship the Lord.